Warning: in this experiment, corrosive acids are used. Gloves should be worn. Greetings, fellow nerds. I've gotten a lot of requests for this, so in this video, we're going to make ferric chloride, a useful chemical to etch copper-clad printed circuit boards. Start with 20 grams of iron. I'm using iron nails, but steel wool also works. Use whatever iron source is cheaper for you. Now add to it 100 milliliters of water and then add 100 milliliters of concentrated 12 molar hydrochloric acid. The acid should start dissolving the iron. This can take a couple of days if you're using nails. Steel wool dissolves within a few hours, but if you're impatient like me, you can speed up the dissolution by heating up the mixture. I'm going to put this round bottom flask of cold water on top to recondense any vapors. And there it goes. Obviously, if you're going to boil acid, do this outside or in a fume hood. What's happening at this point is the iron is reacting with the acid to produce hydrogen gas and green iron 2 chloride, also known as ferrous chloride. Once the iron is completely dissolved, turn off the heating and let it cool. If any of the acid evaporated or boiled off, just top it up with more acid until the total volume is back to 200 milliliters. Now with lots of stirring, slowly add 200 milliliters of 3% hydrogen peroxide. Do this in small portions since the mixture will heat up a lot. If it gets too hot to hold, slow down and wait for it to cool before adding the rest. What we're doing here is oxidizing the ferrous chloride into iron 3 chloride, better known as ferric chloride. If you don't want to use hydrogen peroxide, then a cheaper way to oxidize it is to bubble air through the solution using an aquarium pump. Okay, I recommend using something a bit stronger than this pathetically weak pump, but it will still work. Over the course of several days, the oxygen will slowly react with ferrous chloride to produce ferric chloride. This also has the added advantage of keeping the solution more concentrated than the hydrogen peroxide method. Of course, the hydrogen peroxide method is faster if you're impatient. Anyway, however you oxidize it, it's now ready for etching printed circuit boards. To test it, we just stick in a small strip of bare copper-clad board. After a few minutes, we have etched off the copper. Obviously, in an actual PCB production run, you would stir the mixture so you don't get that small piece of unetched copper at the bottom. Anyway, we have successfully made ferric chloride. You can store it as is, or you can evaporate it to get ferric chloride crystals that take up much less space. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, and comment.